Jordy here for Cinecom.net and welcome to another Creative Tuesday. Today there's no sponsor because I'd like to give some attention to trees, but more about that later because first I'd like to start with the first visual effect that is super easy and super fast and can be done completely inside Adobe Premiere Pro. Starting off with the invisible effect. Film yourself on some location with a green screen. We are filming in a forest because we like trees. And make sure that the camera sits on a tripod, because when you get your shot, you move out of the frame and take an empty shot. In Premiere Pro, place your empty shot on the bottom of the timeline, and on top of there goes the green screen shot. With the top clip selected, head over to the effects controls, and under opacity, click on the pen tool. You want to draw inside the green screen to isolate that. When you're done, search for the ultra key effect and drag that to the top clip and use the color picker to remove the green. The keying itself doesn't have to be perfect. Then right click on this clip and choose nest to group it into a new sequence. And that's because we're going to add the effect called texturize onto the first video layer. Now through the options of this effect, we can assign video 2 as the texture layer, which is the green screen shot. We can now disable the output of that track as we don't need its output anymore. And as you can see, that reveals yourself as something transparent. However, we see this green magenta edge around the talons, and that's something that we'd like to get rid of. To do that, hold down the Alt key and drag the empty shot or the bottom layer to the top to duplicate it. With the top clip selected, head over to the effects controls and remove the texturize effect from it. Then change the blending mode under opacity to color, and that's it. Here's the scoop, guys. The big corporations, they don't want us to plant trees. And that's why we have to go invisible. We did it. Now let's plant some trees. Ah! Oh, Jordy, I hurt myself planting a tree. And now I've got a wound. Well, no worries. With Premiere Pro, I can give myself the power of regeneration. Since Premiere Pro doesn't have a tracker, you want to film your hand or anything else and keep it super still. And that's all you need. In Premiere Pro, place that clip in your timeline and look for a stock clip of some wound, which you can place on top of that. Using the mask tool, you can draw around the wound to cut it out. Position it to the right spot, and with Lumetri, we can color correct it so that it matches better with our skin. If you did move in your shot, you're gonna need to animate the position property so that it follows your movement. Or if you know how to use After Effects, of course, that program has a built-in tracker. Then right-click on this clip and choose Nest to group it into a new sequence. We have to do this in order to make the next effect work, which is Roughen Edges. Apply it to the nested sequence. Now, increasing the border value will bite into the wound and make it disappear. So you can already go ahead and animate that value from 0 to when the wound is gone. Now, within the Roughen Edges effect, I'm going to take the pen tool to draw a mask around the wound, but this time a little bit closer into it. After that, I feather the mask so that the wound blends better with the skin. This is essentially the effect. That was a close one. Now at this rate, I can never plant 20 million trees. So here's what, guys, I'm gonna take my fast arm swinging ability. Yeah, that's also something that I can do. All right, this one is super easy and super fun to make. What you wanna do is film yourself on a tripod as you just roll your arm. Then stand really still on the same spot as someone else changes the shutter speed of the camera. You want to get a slower shutter speed so that you introduce more motion blur. Then just roll your arm again for a very long time. In Premiere Pro, you place the normal shutter speed shot on the bottom of your timeline and the slow shutter speed shot on top of there. With the top clip selected, take the pen tool under opacity and draw a mask around your arm. You want to feather your mask a bunch to make the two clips blend better together, and of course use Lumetri to decrease the exposure, because shooting with a longer shutter speed also makes the clip brighter. Finally, take the great stretch tool and speed up the clip. And that's it. All right, let's do this. Yeah, this is way better. Oh no! I've been planting plastic trees the entire time, guys. No worries, guys. I can give myself laser eyes to burn away all the plastic trees, so we can start again and use real trees. For this, you'll simply need a shot of you acting like you're shooting lasers out of your eyes. That's it. In Premiere Pro, I'm going to search for the lightning effects and drag that to the clip. I only need one straight line, so I'm going to change the amplitude to 0 and the branching as well to 0. Next, make the line a little bit wider through the width property. And of course, you can also change the color to something else that you'd like. Now it's just a simple matter of animating the start point and the end point so that it follows your eyes and that the laser shoots. Now it works best if you keep the animation short and make it go really fast. To top it off, you can add an overlay effect to the video, such as debris or smoke. Now you can find such overlays on stock websites such as Storyblocks Video. And although they're not sponsoring today, I do like to mention them as it's a service that I can highly recommend. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. Basically, you just add such an element on top of your video, change its blending mode to either screen or to ads, and then reposition them. That's it. I got laser eyes. Let's get rid of them. All right, and now let's plant some real trees. As you guys have probably seen, a lot of YouTubers are raising money to plant trees. Now, it's a fundraising that YouTuber MrBeast has started, and he wants to plant 20 million trees by 2020. So there's not much time left. Now, and that's a lot, which is why we're all helping to achieve that, because in the end, it is not going to be an achievement for MrBeast, but rather an achievement for all of us, for humanity. For every dollar donated, the Arbor Day Foundation will plant one tree, so even $1 is already making a difference. Simply click the first link in the description below or go straight to teamtrees.org for all of the information. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, stay green. Faster. Here's what I have. A fast swinging arm. I'm fast, man. I can see Trump doing this, saying like, hey, I'm gonna do a charity thing. I'm gonna plant trees. I've spoken to a plastic company. No worries, guys. The taxes will just raise a little bit, but it's okay.